My name is Amar. I'm the Youth and Participation Officer at East. And I've got a short piece prepared titled Young. I want to talk about the reality of black and brown children, black and brown people, young black and brown people. The reality is that our development is riddled with racism since birth. Our black mothers are disproportionately die under childbirth. Our children grow up without mothers. In school, Muslim girls have had their headscarf pulled off at 9 years old. He never said sorry to me, she says. They're told to wear short skirts, which are not in line with their traditions. In year three, children of Afro-Caribbean background are called dirty skin. Young. In year five, they are told to shut up, you Asian immigrant. Imagine the impact of all of that on a developing child. 13-year-old black boys are pushed and killed into rivers. Christopher Kapasa say his name without justice. Young. People are not taught racism is wrong. Our history is only taught from the lens of slavery and colonization, but those are just symptoms of a non-inclusive curriculum. Decolonize our curriculum, young. At university, we are not allowed to become doctors and nurses. I don't want to be seen by a doctor of this color. And the dropout rate lies at 50% for black university students in Wales. We complain about racism, but nothing ever gets done. Our attainment gap is bigger than it ever was, but it's only a symptom of a disease, young. We are seen as criminals by police who are not protecting us. Our killers roam free without prosecution for 20 years. Stephen Lawrence, say his name. Young, we are disproportionately stopped and searched, disproportionately experienced police use of force, disproportionately killed by the hands of police. Mahmoud Hassan, say his name. Our poor mental health gets treated like a crime, and our treatment is constantly being denied. Mahmoud Ayad Bashir, say his name. Young, our problem lies in institutions that are killing us, institutions that let victims go without justice, institutions that let victims become the perpetrators. Firisi Yanda, say her name. Young. Institutions are not going to silence us. 10 years for a peaceful protest, and this is only a symptom of a disease called institutional racism. We don't need words, surveys, and consultations. We need actions. In our 25 years on this earth as young, only 25 years, racism has infringed our development. Young, reform needs to happen now. We shall defund the police, because in our conversations with them, they ask for evidence for police brutality, that they want victims to come forward, but that's not a commonality because we don't trust them. They shout we want more diversity, but the problem lies in a culture that where police are never prosecuted for their crimes. Criminals cannot be protecting our streets. Young. Young and free, that's all we want. So sit down and listen to us. Don't deny, demand. Demand our justice, because young black lives matter.
Wow. That is a masterpiece. I have to say, we bow to the young. We bow to the young, I'm telling you. You caught the feeling for every single person around this room. And we thank you for holding that thought. You said you speak for young people. You did it. So thank you.